How much did Stanford and being a Stanford athlete prepare you to be a professional, Nneka? And I don't even mean a professional basketball player, but a professional in general.
Huge. It was huge. I mean, obviously, the rigor on the court definitely prepared me for the WNBA. But the maturation that I experienced in school, in the classroom, and in extracurriculars, without a doubt, prepared me to be a businesswoman and a professional after my collegiate career. You know, you learn to meet new people and you learn to make use of those connections and to establish some really great relationships that can help you along the way. And that's a big thing that Stanford taught me.
On the court at Stanford, you went to the Final Four every year that you played with the Cardinals. So four Final Fours, but never could quite break through and win a championship. Now having won that title with the LA Sparks and the WNBA, do you feel like that weight's been lifted? You finally broke through and got to the pinnacle of your sport?
Yeah, you know, when you want something so badly or you want to achieve something so badly, once you get it, you really think more so about the journey that it took to get you there. And so those were kind of the thoughts that were rolling through my mind as we were celebrating the championship. And Stanford, without a doubt, was a huge block of that memory. You know, I saw a lot of success at Stanford, maybe didn't quite reach the top, but it was definitely a part of the process for me. And I'm very grateful for all the experiences that I shared with my teammates. And of course, Tara Vanderveer and the staff, they really shaped me into the person and the player that I am today.
Well, and certainly being at Stanford, a program of that level helped you to develop this fantastic work ethic. And I loved watching the video that you had on WNBA.com in which you talked about how that is the part that you actually cherish, the practices, the work behind the scenes to help you get better once the bright lights come on. How much does that have to do with the success, the championship, and of course, winning the MVP?
Oh, man, the older that you get, you know, a lot of people might think that it's less so about the practices and it's more so about the skill and the talent. But in my opinion, the older that you get and the more games you play, the more experience you get, it's more about the smaller things. And you can't let go of those things because that's what got you here and that's what's going to sustain you. And so I always advise younger athletes to stick by what you know, stick by what you do, and take it step by step. Don't put too much on your plate. But whether you think you can or you can't do it, you're probably right. So you might as well believe that you can.
Yeah, that's a strong philosophy for sure. Spending a couple of minutes with Nneka Ogwumike, who is the reigning WNBA MVP and also a member of the champion LA Sparks, will be presenting the Capital One Cup to Stanford athletes. She's a Stanford alum that's coming up on the ESPYs on Wednesday night. So Nneka, you have the WNBA, then you play in Russia when you're not participating here in the United States. When do you ever get time off?
Yeah, I mean, I try to make use of all the off days that I have. And then in between seasons, you get a week or two. So you really have to maximize on that. But you kind of learn how to pace yourself. And I don't necessarily mean pacing yourself in the game, but understanding how your body reacts and what's best for you when it comes to recovery. So rest is not a four-letter word for me. And a big part, because we don't get breaks, a big part of my rest has to do with my habits and my diet and my regimen. So I really try to adhere to that to make it as easy as possible for my body.
Definitely something that WNBA players have in common with soccer players here in the U.S. And I ask them this question whenever I have a chance to talk to them too, about the growth of the sport and the response of the fans here inside the United States. So in your time in the league, how have you seen the sport itself grow and the support grow from fans across the country?
Oh man, it's been great, you know. And I'm a student of the game, but I couldn't even really say that I know as much about the history of the game as other people may have. And I've learned more history being in it, of course. But each year is more exciting, and you see it. I think you see growth when you change your perspective about it, and when you talk to people who are fans of yours, and then they bring their own friends. I think it's very important for people to come and watch a game physically. That's when people really get hooked. And so when that happens, you see the game grow. And I would say the one, I guess, experience that signifies the growth that I've experienced was in our final series last year. I think it was probably one of the most watched sporting events in a while. And it was all the way down to the wire. And I think that was great for sports.
For sure. And then in addition to that, women's basketball fans got a stunning upset at this year's Final Four, and that helps too. These players now graduating and moving on to the WNBA, and fans will follow them. In your time at Stanford, as well as with the LA Sparks, you've played with some amazing teammates, including your sister. But we all know that Candace Parker is a household name. What's it like to play alongside her in Los Angeles?
Oh, man. I always try to tell people that Candace can do it all, and it's my job to let her know that she doesn't have to. So that's kind of the role that I've found myself playing. And we've grown in our relationship on and off the court to help each other realize that. So there are times when you really have to make sure that you're paying attention, because she can make plays that will distract you just simply because of how amazing she is on the court. And I just want to be able to help her and to highlight the championship player that she is.
Well, it's a winning combination since the Sparks are the WNBA reigning champs. Nneka Ogwumike with us here after hours on CBS Sports Radio. She's the MVP and will be presenting at the ESPYs, the Capital One Cup, as part of her Stanford past. So, Nneka, you have three younger sisters. You're the oldest of four. What was it like to grow up in a household with four girls?
It's not as bad as most people would think it is. I mean, you know, there's certain rules that we have when it comes to sharing and wearing each other's clothes, but at the end of the day, it's four sisters, but we always kind of joke around and say that we also had four boys because we all play sports. If the news isn't on in our house, it's ESPN or NBA TV. So it was a very interesting dynamic, but it created a really fine balance.
Well, you're the first to go through this process, but your sister Chine is now in the WNBA as well. What kind of advice and wisdom have you shared with her, as well as your other sisters, as the first one to blaze this trail?
I mean, what I experienced, I had a great rookie experience in the WNBA and overseas. I tried my best to tell Chine, hey, do what got you here, and then you can move from there. Don't try to do too much. Stick to what you know and be true to yourself. And that's the advice I try to give all of these other young athletes. And I think that once you stick to that, then you really can't go wrong.
I have a younger brother who plays basketball too, and I remember being far more nervous when I was in the stands supporting him than I ever got when I was on the court myself. You've got not only Chine, but a couple of other younger sisters. As you say, you all play sports. What's that dynamic like for you when you're watching them as opposed to playing?
Oh, yes. I feel the exact same way. I always get nervous watching Chine, even till this day. When I'm watching myself or when I'm out there playing, you know, it's different. And you're like, oh, you know, you can handle a little bit more. And even though I know that Chine is strong and she can handle things too, you still have that protective air when you're watching and supporting. And she's the same with me. We support each other. She's probably a bigger fan than I am when it comes to supporting me on the court. And I try my best to support her as well, because she's really stepped out into the business world and into the analyst world. She works for ESPN, and I'm very proud of what she's done out of her situation with injury. So we just try to be each other's rocks.
I remember reading that you and Chine got asked to do the body issue previously as a pair, and you decided it wasn't the right time, and also that your parents weren't super thrilled about the idea. You do it, though, this year, 2017. Why did you decide this was the right opportunity?
I mean, when they asked us earlier, you know, it was definitely something that I've always wanted to do, and I thought it would have been awesome to do with Chine too. But, you know, we're two very different people, so I think I was a bit more comfortable than she was to do it. And at the end of the day, she was still letting me know how my picture – she was on FaceTime when I was doing it, so it was still pretty fun, and I was able to share the pictures with her. And it was just one of those type of dream things that you want to do. You know, it's something that you've always looked up to. And I also know that they don't just ask anybody. And so I was very honored to be a part of it. And I'm very pleased with how it turned out. And I've gotten so much great feedback.
Well, good. I'm glad you brought that up, because in this day and age of social media, everyone has a chance to react and to respond. And here you are literally putting your whole self out there, Nneka. So what's the reaction been like to your body issue?
I think one is that a lot of people didn't expect me to do it, and so I didn't tell anyone that I was really doing it. So it was a surprise for me to be doing it. But I think that it also kind of showed this confidence that I have about myself that some people who know me have. Know me to have, or some people that may not know me want to know a little bit more about how I feel about myself. And I was just very confident to be able to do it. But so far, so good. You know, it's been pretty amazing. I'm very thankful.
Well, good for you, Nneka. I'm not sure I would have had the same courage, so I'm very impressed. And the pictures turned out great. You did fantastic. Last thing before I let you go, you mentioned people surprised because you did the body issue. Well, you said last year you were stunned when you won the WNBA MVP. Why that reaction, considering the year that you had?
I mean, you know, it's just, I don't know. That award to me, it seems so high on the shelf, and it's not to say that I couldn't reach it, but you don't think about it while you're doing it, you know? It's not something that, for me, it wasn't something that I was like, okay, this is my goal, you know? It was just a year where I wanted to play well, I wanted to do well for my team, but more importantly, I wanted to win and leave everybody with a great experience. So even down to the wire, when it looked like it was going to veer towards my way, I was still very surprised. It was definitely a memory to hold on to.
Well, it's certainly been quite a year. WNBA champ, the MVP. We talked about the body issue. You got a lot going on right now, Nneka. What other goals do you have, though, since you just brought that up?
I mean, right now, I think my goal is to just continue to be great and to continue to move forward. I don't want to ever feel like I'm in the same place. And if that means winning another championship, getting Defensive Player of the Year sometime down the line, being an Olympian, then that's what comes with it. I think that once I have that overall arching goal to be great, then things will come. But most importantly, I really want to be able to leave people with a great experience, saying that they had a great experience with me as a teammate or me as a person.
Well, those are definitely goals that you can work toward for the entire rest of your career, whether it's here or whether it's in Russia. Nneka Ogwumike is the WNBA MVP and a member of the reigning champion LA Sparks. We'll also be presenting at the ESPYs, the Capital One Cup, along with Eddie George, as you hand it off to Stanford on the women's side, and he gives it to Ohio State for the men. It was great to catch a couple of minutes with you. Thank you so much for all your time.
Thank you. So nice talking to you.